The purpose of this video is to provide you with a high-level overview of the Auro3D workflow. In fact, there are two concepts from which content can be realized in the Auro3D sound format. First is in the final mix only. Second is when Auro3D is factored from in the beginning. Let's start with the first one. In the final mix only, in which a standard workflow is enhanced with the creative possibilities of the Auro3D 11.1 format. This enables a much more natural spread of sound, resulting in a much more immersive cinema experience. The concept and the goal is that we have in fact two different sound formats, the Auro3D 11.1 and the 5.1, which will be created simultaneously. That's possible due to two things. First, the speaker layout. There is a natural compatibility between the 5.1 and the 11.1 format. And secondly, of course, the tools. We provide you with the tools that enables a perfect result of an Auro3D 11.1 and an even enhanced 5.1 surround master. In this video, I'm going to focus on the final mix only. So there are a few aspects very important in creating a three-dimensional sound field. Of course, it's routing, the 3D panning, but there are some more things like you need sometimes upmixing, and of course, the tools you need for the compatibility to create the 11.1 simultaneously with the 5.1. I'll take you through on the screen and let's look how this works. So if all the channels are coming together on a console, it's important to create first in the 11.1 the three-dimensional sound field. That can be done by routing, 3D routing and 3D panning, of course, combined. Certain sounds can immediately route it to certain specific places, especially the high channels, which are very important for the three-dimensional sound field. With the ceiling channels only, we cannot recreate that three-dimensional sound field. Certain sounds can immediately go up there, like birds or certain effects can immediately put up there. But other sounds really need a control of being panned to put them more precisely on certain positions and sometimes if they move as well. For that one, we developed a special 3D panner which can be used in the Pro Tools environment or you can do it as well on the mixing console. On the mixing console, it works like that. So using these two joysticks here on the DFC console from AMS Neef, it's in fact very easy. On the left side, you have the horizontal plane, on the right side, the vertical one. So with the combination of both, we can place whatever sound in the three-dimensional space. The same concept can be done as well in the Pro Tools, where the same two concepts, two joysticks are put in the position so that you can recreate the same thing, but then in the Pro Tools system itself. Another important tool as well, what we need is sometimes upmixing. If you have like one basic three-dimensional sound field, that you need for a certain sound some upmixing. We felt a few times, even strangely enough, with dialogue. If you have a very natural sound field and certain sounds which are recorded in mono but with a lot of echo around it, which are only produced in the center field, it gives not that kind of, let's say, natural spread. So just adding a little bit of reflection brings the voice immediately to that three-dimensional sound field. We need this tool just to make it easier to recreate that natural environment. So you see here the Auro3D plugin, which different configurations we can choose. The related fader setup is immediately coming into this fader panel. There is a routing panel as well, which connects us with the Pro Tools. Pro Tools is limited to an 8-channel bus. With this tool, we can go up till 16 bus channel, which allows, of course, then the 3D routing and panning. The concept is that the high channel is encoded into the lower one, but encoded is in a creative way. This means we are just mixing as on a normal mixing panel. We are mixing this both PCM channels, and the end result is again a PCM channel. Each speaker is related to a channel here. So, and the idea is that the high channels are going to be mixed into the lower ones. And that requires sometimes some fine tuning of the levels, which can be automated and done with these faders. This is the way you can evaluate the 5.1 mix, so it is encoding, because this plugin is used as an insertion on the final mix bus. If you go to bypass, then you have the 11.1 mix. If you go to evaluate, then you can hear the exactly 5.1 mix. I hope this video gives you a little insight of the tools available now to create in an easy way Auro 3D content. If you would like to have more information, please visit our website and you will be convinced about and the technical and the creative possibilities of the Auro 3D format.